Hey folks, Troy Klongerbo here with USGolfTV. We've got the XE1 wedge in our hands. It just came in the mail last week. We've got the XE1 65 degree wedge. You guys have seen all over the Golf Channel. A lot of you guys have visited our blog, read all about it. We've had some critiques on it. We've had some reviews on it. But now we've actually got the club in our hands and we're able to test it out. So when I first got this club a couple weeks ago, I noticed a few things. I noticed, first of all, the lightweight nature of the club. The head, the shaft, everything about it is lightweight, a little bit lighter than any typical wedge that I've ever used. I noticed that the club was a cast head as opposed to a forged head. Typically you want to work with forged heads in your wedges to give you more consistency, but I can explain more about that in the meta description or in our blog here. You guys can just click on cast or forged. But I noticed that it was a cast wedge, which actually helps in the design. They needed to get a big cutout in the back here, and they needed to make sure that the club was fairly efficient to produce. And cast helps with all that. But when I first look at the club, it's obvious that they have this massive sole on the bottom of the club, similar to the Alien wedge back in the early 2000s. It's really a wedge that's designed for forgiveness. It's not designed to be a versatile club. It's designed to help golfers get out of trouble and get out of trouble fast. And what I will say after working with the club for about 30 minutes is it does. It gets you out of trouble. If you're in the rough or in the sand or in an awkward lie in the fairway, if you work with this club properly, it will help you. Now, I'll start with a couple of the detractions from the club. First of all, when I noticed I was trying to hit a few different shots, when I was trying to hit low shots or I was trying to hit shots that run out, this club wasn't able to really execute on those. Part of it has to do with the bounce, but a lot of it has to do with the loft being 65 degrees. But pretty much every single shot comes out with some level of trajectory and stops fairly quick. And that leads me into a nice transition into the positives of the club, which means it comes out with a nice trajectory and it lands nice and quick. A lot of golfers that are looking to escape from bunkers, roughs, they're probably sick of seeing their ball fly over the green or skip across the green or come out chasing into the woods. But with this club performs. The ball comes out high, it lands soft. Surprisingly, it had a lot of spin, which I was going to be a little bit skeptical of knowing it's a cast iron club. I was able to get the ball to off down slope, stop, into up slope, stop, hitting from different lies, come out nice and high. And there's a lot of merit to that product right there. Now, I don't know if this club's gonna save you a stroke a hole. I can't even promise that it's gonna save you 6 strokes per round, like many of the advertisements indicate. But what I can say after working with it is there is some merit to it, and there is merit to the design and what it's trying to accomplish. And if you're a golfer that's looking to get out of bunkers in one shot, or if you're a guy who's hitting out of the rough and struggles with confidence, this club's gonna help you. I worked with it in a few different ways. I worked with it from a really steep angle of attack, a really shallow angle of attack, a squared off approach, a lot of different ways, trying to simulate what other golfers would be able to use with this club, and it performed from all of them. So if you guys are looking for a club that can help you guys get out of the bunkers, get out of the roughs, get onto the green and start putting, the XE1 wedge is not a bad idea, and it's something worth checking out. So if you guys want more information on this club, we've got information on our website or in the meta description below. And if you guys want more instructional stuff, feel free to stay here on our YouTube channel or head over to usgolftv.com.